So when we bought the house in 2004, the prior owners had done a terrific job of adding the addition on the right side of the house, the three-car garage below, the great family room on the first floor, and the large master suite on the second floor. But other than adding central air conditioning, they'd really left most of the rest of the house untouched, and it had been that way for many years. So for the first couple of years we lived here, we did a fair amount of structural work. Some of that included replacing all of the wiring from the old knob and tube up to modern electrical wiring. We upgraded the security system by installing door and window and glass break detectors, motion sensors, and additional smoke detectors. We did some work on the structural aspects of the house. We insulated the home with blown-in cellulose and foam in the attic. We installed storm windows over many of the older windows of the house, and for some of the old windows, we actually hired a window restoration specialist to come in, disassemble them, rebuild them, and weather strip them. And at the same time, during that period, we also worked on some interior moldings and installed some stair railings and high security door locks. The following year, when the weather turned better, we took the opportunity to paint the exterior of the house. We added some additional crown and dental molding and modillions on the addition from the 1930s to match the original house, replaced some of the old clapboards, and then had the house painted, working with a specialist consultant in historic home colors. In 2006, we installed some humidifiers in the home, and in 2009, when the first floor furnace stopped working, we took the opportunity to replace it with a high-efficiency two-stage furnace and a new air conditioning compressor and humidifier. Starting in 2009, we undertook about a year and a half of re-landscaping around the property. One of our major goals was to turn the backyard into a terrific entertaining space. So we built a bluestone terrace with sitting walls, room for yard furniture, and in addition, landscaped along the back of the house to improve the privacy. It turned into a terrific exterior entertaining space, which we used many times. Along with that project, we rebuilt many of the other stone walls on the property. We installed new drainage under the driveway and then replaced the old asphalt driveway with a paver driveway. And then we put up new exterior lighting as well to brighten up the whole outside of the house when we were using it. So in 2012, we had the opportunity to do some additional work in the house. And among the things that we did during that time were have all of the floors stripped, sanded, and refinished, especially the old red birch original floors on the first floor. We installed new crown moldings that were custom made in the study on the first floor and in the lavatory. Installed a brand new lighting system using the Lutron automatic control system on the first floor, and installed a smart house system to control the thermostats, the lighting, potentially security, TV and audio, intercom, and all kinds of other features throughout the house. In the way of plumbing work, we had all the drains snaked and cleaned and then put in two brand new hot water heaters and then upgraded the carbon monoxide monitoring system as part of the security system. We also took advantage of the opportunity to paint some interior portions of the house, have all of the ducts cleaned thoroughly, and do some minor structural repairs. So after all this work, you might say, well, why not stay in the house? And it's been a terrific place to be for the last 10 and a half years, but it's time for another family to have the opportunity to live in the home that we've worked on and that several owners before us have been caretakers of.